So let us do some practical questions based on what we have learned. So practical questions, yes. See, dekhiye, exporting country, cost of the machine at Singapore. See, we imported from Singapore. Import Singapore, say. And what is the cost there in Singapore? He is charging $10,000. Transport in exporting country, that is transport in Singapore. Singapore ka jo transport hai, $500. And loading charges into the ship, because the goods have to be put in the ship, inside the ship. Ship ke andar dalna. $50. And buying commission. The buying commission is obviously means the commission payable to the agent of the importer. See, I am importer, I am paying to my agent. If you see clearly, rule 10, commission is to be added other than buying commission. So buying commission is not a part of value. Jodne ki zarurat nahi hai. Then freight from Singapore to India. So we are getting goods from Singapore to India, there are freight charges. Vase ayatak lane ka. So when we add, so we have to find out. The US dollar, say let me put it like this. One US dollar is equal to, let us say, 60 rupees. One US dollar is equal to, as per CBEC notification. Only CBEC notification valid, you know. So we can do it very easily. So how do you do it? Computation of value. Bada asaan hai. Computation of value. Number one, cost $10,000. Then transport. Number one, number two, number three, number four, number five. So number two, add number two, transport in exporting country 500, very simple. Add number three, that is loading charges into the ship, tabhi FOB banega, that we'll make up to make FOB, it is necessary to add. Yes, we have added. And buying commission, no. Buying commission, we don't have to add. Judega nahi. And then, freight from Singapore to India. Yes, freight charges are included. That is 1,000. Now the question is, where is insurance? Because insurance is necessary to bring the goods from there to India. Wo to hai nahi yahan pe. It's not there. But we have to add. Without insurance, it's not possible to bring goods to India. So, jodna jaruri hai. So, if details are not available, simply 1.125% of FOB. So, 1.125% of FOB first of all, find out FOB. FOB before adding freight charges. $10,550, right? It is cost plus transport plus loading charges. It is FOB. Okay, buying commission not to be added. Then once we get the FOB, add freight as freight 1,000. Add insurance 1.125% of 10,550, right? Check here. 1.125%. 1.125% is coming here. 118.69. It is there. 118.69. To be on safe side, check kar lete. 10,550 into 1.125%. Yes, 118.6875 rounded off. Okay, let's do it. We should not round off. Okay, kabhi ho sakta hai, chalega. 11,668.69, and in Indian rupees, multiply it by 60, whatever be the value, you get 7,121. The issue is in Indian rupees. The issue is here. We got the answer, computation of value. This itself is CF value. This is CF value is 7,121. That itself is assessable value. That itself is customs value. There is no provision like landing charges now. Aisa kuch nahi hai. Right? So that's how we calculate the values. It is as simple as that. Ek aur dekhenge. Let's see the other one. Let's put another question. It's very simple, na? Nahi? Bahut simple hai. Next, let's have another question. Simple question. This question is computation of assessable value. Computation of assessable value and duty. So let us compute the assessable value. See, the customs officer computed its FOB value at $20,000. $20,000 including development charges. Okay. Including development charges, it is 20,000. FOB value including, here I write FOB including, question number 2, development charges. So development charges not here, outside India. Yaad rakhna. Yeah, this is outside India. So obviously it's a part of value. It is $20,000. Done. And then what else is saying? Which was borne by the supplier, okay. Which was borne by the supplier means supplier ne bear kiya. Iska matlab, it means it incurred outside India. So we include customs officer computed, okay. Then freight paid by air. By air it is, by air freight it is $4,500. Okay. Design development charges paid in India, paid outside. Okay, it's irrelevant. How much it was paid? Design development charges paid in USA, 2,500, but it is already included. We don't have to consider again. And exchange rate, it's okay. Exchange rate is there. We can do it. And what about duties? Duties are also given. Exchange rate is 60.60. Rate of exchange, let us take it at 60.60 as notified by CBEC. And fair aage. Duties they have given. Duties they have given. Customs details. What about insurance? Insurance details. Commission payable to an agent in India. 12,500 rupees. There is a catch here. Commission payable to agent in India. This is in Indian rupees. See, 12,500, this is rupees, this is dollars. Yaad rakhna. Okay. So then, what else is there? Rate of duties. They have given rate of duties also. Basic custom duty, 30%. And IGST, 12%. Let us say 12%. Basic custom duty, let us calculate duties also. 30%. And IGST, 12%. How do we calculate? We'll do. First of all, find out assessable value. Iske baad duties. Okay. So this is FOB including development charges, where development charges are 2500, but including no, so we don't have to add anything extra. That is all together 20,000. And air freight commission payable to agent in India. Okay, nothing else is there. So how do you find out FOB for the purpose of custom? Computation of, see how we do computation of assessable value. First four heading, computation of assessable value. What we do is FOB including development charges, that is 20,000 USD. Okay. Add commission. See, for the purpose of customs FOB, we have to add commission here. Why I am adding this? This is not a buying commission. A buying commission nahi hai. Kyon nahi hai? See here, it's not buying commission because commission payable to agent, they did not mention it is a buying commission. Wo toh bataya nahi. So I take it. I take it that he is the agent of exporter. So it is in Indian rupees. So what I do is, in Indian rupees, I will calculate Indian rupees 20,000 at the rate of 60. First of all, I think 12 lakhs. Is it 12 lakhs? Yes, 12 lakh rupees. And add commission in Indian rupees, 12,500. I have put in Indian rupees. Indian rupees mein convert kiya. Because the commission is in Indian rupees. So now I have got 12,500 in Indian rupees. Then this is FOB for the purpose of customs. Customs FOB. This is FOB for customs purpose. That was FOB, but this is for the purpose of customs. So fir 12,500. 12,500. And then add freight charges. Freight at the rate of 20%. It cannot exceed 20%. So if you see this, 4,500 is by any standard it is above. Yes. So 20% will be coming to 242,500. I am restricting it to 20% only. It cannot be more than 20%. It's a jada hoi nahi sakta. So 242,500 freight charges because it is by air, and add insurance. Insurance at the rate of 1.15% of this. 1.15%, it comes to be 644. Okay, 13,640.63, 641, okay. So we have made FOB by adding commission. This is the change. So put together in Indian rupees, it is 14,68,641. 14,68,641 rupees. Done. This is CF value and this is also assessable value. Assessable value, CF value, both are same. No landing charges, no 1% to be added. Done. So then, how do you calculate duties? Let me also calculate the duties and show you. Value one column, dusre column mein duty. Value one column and duties. Duty or tax. Now it is GST, no? Then assessable value. Add BCD at the rate of 30%. What is the percentage? Say 30%. 68,640. 30%, it is 4,40,592. 4,40,592. 4,40,592. I am maintaining another column. Duty rupees, value rupees. BCD. And on BCD, add cess at the rate of 3%. Put together. If you add cess at 3%, $13,218, I am rounding off, $13,218. So we got basic custom duty plus cess. Okay, so on this total we have to pay iske upar IGST jodenge, we have to add IGST. So after this 1922 450, this is value. How much is 1922 450? This is 8,354. Please check up the calculations yourself. Use the calculator. Calculator se check up kar lijiye. Okay. So then, add IGST. IGST is at the rate of 12% on this one. If you add IGST, it comes to be 230694. So total will be 21,53,144. Okay, 1,54,86,684. It is as simple as that. Samajh mein aa raha hai? Both easy, very simple. So what we have done is, we have added commission to make FOB, and on that FOB we have added freight and insurance. Restricted to 20% because it is by air. Insurance 1.15%. We got a assessable value. On assessable value we added, dekha yahan pe, customs, basic custom duty plus cess, 3%. On the total we added IGST. Okay. Let us see another question. We can do another question. One more question we can do. Heading important. Computation of assessable value, computation of value, computation of duties, like that. Put proper heading. Bahut jaruri hai. Okay. Let us have another question. It's also very simple. FOB value of the machine, 10,000 pounds. FOB value, 10,000 pounds. 10,000 pounds. Plus freight, 3,000 pounds. Freight, 3,000 pounds. And then license fee, buyer was required to pay in UK, 400 pounds. License fee which the buyer is required to pay, means it's compulsory part of it, without which import cannot be made. Iske bina import ho hi nahi sakta. Buying commission paid in India, 20,000. Buying commission, 20,000 rupees. So irrelevant for us. Hamare liye to iska importance nahi hai. And rate of duty, integrated insurance details not available. IGST, 20%. And rate of duty, obviously there would be rate of duty. Rate of duty, 10% integrated. Exchange rate, 99. 1 pound is equal to rupees 99. Basic custom duty, 10%. The job is done. It is as simple as that. So how do you find out? Is it by air? Yes, by air, 3,000 UK pounds. Right? By air. That is the catch. You have imported by air. They have given FOB. There is no issue. Issue is very simple and easy. So, assessable value. How do you find out assessable value? Computation of assessable value. Take FOB. 10,000. Of course, pounds. So, license fee you have to add. Add license fee first. Then if you add, it is 400. Then we get customs value. FOB, customs FOB. So customs FOB is, after adding this, 10,400. We can add only 20%, na? Freight. Air freight restricted to 20% only. So 20% of this. So 20% of this means 208. 20% how it comes to be, how much it comes to be. So they have converted it into 104 means 208. 2080, right? Let us convert later on. Buying commission, license fees, add insurance. Insurance not given, 1.125% of this one. 1.125%, let us calculate. Yes, done it in 10,400. Into 1.125%. 117. 117 calculations, please you check up, aap khud check up kijiye. 7952 1 12597, right? This is in pounds, 12597. So 12597, after adding insurance, buying commission not to be added, it's not a part of value because they have given clearly. And in Indian rupees at the rate 99, let us calculate 99 into 12,000.12,597, that is 1247 103, right? 1247 103, 12,47,103. You can say CAF value and also assessable value, both are same. Once you got it, calculation of duties baaya haath ka khel hai, it's damn easy. Let's see computation of duties. Rate of duty 10%, basic custom duty, basic custom duty, value one column, duty another column, okay. Assessable value 12,47,103, add BCD at the rate of 10%, so 124710. Let me ignore 124710, let me ignore this fraction, but you need not. You 710 124710, and it is 1871 1371 1371 813, right? Add cess at the rate of 3% on this, you know that. If you add 3% on cess without taking pain, 3712471037411247710, right? So obviously cess will also be right. 3741 3741 3741 4555 713 1 2 8 4 5 1, is it correct? 1 2 8 4 5 1, let us see. Okay, then add IGST. If you add IGST at the rate of 12% on this value, 1375554 1650166, or you can say 66 or 77, 1 rupee difference will be there. 165066. You add the totals. Okay. 1540 1540 plus plus this plus, got it? So calculation of duties is easy, both asan, very easy. But the thing is, once you understand what is to be added for assessable value or for customs value, now CAF value is equal to customs value. Okay, so we will see some more practical questions also, dekhenge. then we'll get into that, right?